Welcome to the Cathedral City. Welcome to Armagh. As we enter into the joy of the Easter season, we can see change all around us. Nature has awakened. New buds on the trees remind us of new life. Snowdrops and daffodils have bloomed. Their bright colours bring a glimmer of sunshine and hope into what has been a most difficult year. And just as our eyes embrace the beauty of nature around us, we look forward with renewed optimism and hope for better days ahead. So rest a while with us as we welcome brighter days through music, reflection and song in this Easter joy from our Cathedral City.
I arise today through the strength of heaven, light of sun, radiance of moon, splendor of fire, speed of lightning, swiftness of wind, depth of the sea, stability of earth, firmness of rock. I arise today through God's strength to pilot me, God's eye to look before me, God's wisdom to guide me, God's way to lie before me, God's shield to protect me. From all who shall wish me ill, afar and anear, against every cruel, merciless power that may oppose my body and soul, Christ with me, Christ before me,
everyone. Welcome to St. Patrick's Cathedral in Armagh for this celebration of Easter joy, a day in which we can all rejoice that Christ our Lord is risen. A very special day, full of hope, full of praise, and full of thanksgiving. And Archbishop John and I hope that you can, through this little moment together, share in some of the joy of this special occasion.
Thank you very much, Archbishop. Lovely to be here and with everyone on Easter Day. And I was just thinking back to last week, to the Feast of the Annunciation on the 25th of March, when the angel announced to Mary that she was to have a son, and she had conceived. And probably completely unknown to her, there was this tiny, tiny change in her physiognomy, in her womb, and the warmth of her womb, she wasn't aware of. But that little change was the beginning of something that would change the whole world. And then 33 years later, in this time, the dark tomb rather than the warm womb, unseen by anyone, Jesus Christ is raised from the dead, and the world can never be the same again, because we've turned the corner in the resurrection from darkness into light.
And I think that very hopeful message of Easter is so important for us this year, because of course we've been struggling through quite a bit of darkness over this last year or so. And we hope that tonight and through this service, you can really enter into the spirit, into the joy of Easter, and Alleluia can be your song too. That Hebrew word which links us right back to the very first Christians who rejoiced that Christ the Lord had risen. He is risen indeed. I hope you really enjoy this event.
He's risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
I will ever is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. Body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the dead he rose again. Now as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought by the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand, till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand, till he returns or calls me home. Here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
My name is Frances Barrett. I live in Eglish in County Tyrone, and I've been working as a community respiratory nurse specialist for the last number of years in Belfast and across the Southern Trust area. This has been a particularly difficult year for all of us, and one that will never be forgotten. It has been particularly difficult for doctors, nurses, and carers in our hospitals and care homes, and all who have been working in the nursing or caring field in communities across our world. This evening, we salute all of them, and we acknowledge all our frontline workers, and we give them thanks. We thank them for their bravery and courage throughout this difficult year. As we gather on this Easter night, and as we celebrate this Easter season, we pray that each one of us that may demonstrate the presence of the risen Lord by living lives that are full of great hope and joy.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Oh, 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 sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, 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 sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble. Were you there when he rose to glorious life? Were you there when he rose to glorious life? Oh, 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 sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when he rose to glorious life?
With no place to call my home, but there's one who holds my hand, the rugged road through barren lands, the way is dark. I find another voice inside my mind. He comforts me and builds.
My name is Betty Devlin. I live in Armagh and I've been involved with the local St. Vincent de Paul Conference for many years, reaching out and helping to support those in need. For the last year, I've been more confined to my home as a result of the pandemic. It has been a very worrying and difficult time for many, and especially those who are old or sick or those who live alone. Many people have been fearful about going out and so as a result have stayed at home. So many people have reached out over the year to help support older people by bringing food and medication, and many have been attending to people's needs. Thankfully, the overall situation has been improving in recent weeks, and we look forward in a spirit of hope to brighter days to come. We pray that the joy of the risen Christ will help sustain us as we move forward and as we look towards better days for all of us.
Last night I lay asleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in all Jerusalem beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, I thought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. I thought the voice of angels from heaven in answer. My dream was changed, the streets no longer rang. Hushed with the glad hosannas, the little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery, the morn was cold and chill, as the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. As the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, hark how the angels sing. Hosanna in the highest, hosanna to changed, new earth there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on its streets, the gates were open wide, and all who would might enter, and no one was denied. No need of moon or stars by night, or sun to shine by day. It was the new Jerusalem that would not
My name is Matthew Kingston and I'm from Armagh. Today, I give thanks on behalf of all young people for the opportunities that we have been given. This past year has been incredibly hard for our youth, but now, as we return to our schools and colleges, we can sense normality slowly beginning to return. During this past year, we have all learned what it is like to do without, to miss the special moments and the important people that give our lives colour and excitement. Perhaps this Easter is a good time for us all to reflect and to think of those throughout the world who could only dream of the many luxuries we do enjoy. Henry W. Longfellow once said, "If spring came but once a century instead of once a year, or burst forth with the sound of an earthquake and not in silence, what wonder and expectation there would be in all hearts to behold the miraculous change." Let us all be thankful this Easter season, and as we look forward to a greater sense of normality, may we open our eyes and hearts to the miracle of each moment.
Look at me, tell me what you see. Understand how much your love has done for me. Is it clear? I will always want you near. Is it written in my eyes how much I love you? From where I stand, you are the silver thread of starlight in the evening, and I could hardly feel my heart before you held it in your hands, and I hope you're never far from where I stand. Beside you, and you've helped me find my way. Honestly, you are still the one for me, and my heart is gonna be with you forever. From where I stand, you are the break of day. Silver thread of starlight in the evening, and I could hardly feel my heart before you held it in your hand, and I hope you're never far from where I stand. And I could hardly feel my heart before you held.
my faith will fail, Christ will hold me fast. When the tempter would prevail, he will hold me fast. I could never keep my hold through this fearful path, for my love is often cold. He must hold me fast. He will hold me fast. He will hold me fast. For my Savior loves me so. He will hold. Precious in his holy sight, he will hold me fast. He'll not let my soul be lost. His promises shall last till our faith is turned to sand. He must hold me fast. Justice has been satisfied. He will hold me fast. Raised with him to endless life, he will hold me fast. Till our faith is turned to sight, when he comes at last.
My name is Pierre Steins, and I have been an active member of our parish community for many years. There have been times, many times, when the going has been tough over the past year, with many saying that we will continue to experience the serious impact of this pandemic for years to come. Our world has literally been turned upside down. Sanitizing, face coverings, social distancing, the list goes on, and has become the new norm for all. And whilst we have been challenged in different ways throughout the year, no challenge has been as great as the challenge of losing a loved one. Just a few weeks back, I lost a family member, and this evening we think of all who have died, and in particular those who have died as a result of COVID-19. We pray that all our loved ones may be sharing in the joy of the resurrection. We pray too that all who have been bereaved may be renewed as a result of Jesus rising from the dead. And may we continue to walk each day in hope towards the fullness of new life in heaven.
Consider all the works thy hand has made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder. Thy power throughout the universe.
Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross our burdens gladly buried, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. Shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. There I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great you are. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art.
Risen Lord, you call us to bring your joy to the world. Alleluia. You invite us to be your body on earth. Alleluia. You mission us to reach out to the fearful and weak. Alleluia. You empower us to reveal your presence to a weary world. Alleluia. You enthuse us to enter deeper into a life assured of resurrection. Alleluia. And so, be with us, Lord, as we continue our pilgrim journey as an Easter people. Guide our footsteps with the light of Easter faith and joy, that we may walk in your ways. We ask this through Christ our Lord, who has risen from the dead. Amen.
Blind, but now I was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved.
How precious did that grace appear.
Thank you.